Today, how our very fallible brain tricks us into finding causality that just isn't there. Hi, I'm Graeme Newell, and I use the latest brain science insights to show you how to make smarter money decisions. My speeches and webinars teach how to recognize the signs that an impulsive decision might be likely. Click subscribe and the bell below to see more of my videos. Do you have any of those weird, irrational superstitions that you do all the time? Maybe it's those lucky socks that always seem to win the game for your team. Perhaps you're convinced bad things will happen if you step on the cracks in the sidewalk. And you know it's going to be a bad day when this fella crosses your path. Now, most of us tell ourselves superstitions aren't really true, but we don't care. We're compelled to do them anyway. Our powerful urge to link random objects to good and bad events isn't just a preference. It's a potent judgment distortion, and it's hardwired into our brains. This is a behavioral finance bias. Neuroscientists call it illusory correlation bias, and it's our brain's continuous habit of seeking associations where none exist. Why do we so easily fall for these false connections? Because oodles of connections make our brains remarkably efficient. Back in caveman times, the greatest threat to our survival was lack of food. The human brain consumes a whopping 20% of our body energy. So achieving maximum thinking while consuming the minimum amount of energy often meant the difference between life and death. A super efficient brain gave us the best chance of survival. That's why our mind is obsessed with finding structure in a world of randomness. And one of the most effective ways to do this is to generalize. So your caveman brain learned to associate eating grass with a terrible taste. And now anything that looks like lawn clippings, you probably don't need to stick in your mouth anymore. Thanks to this generalization skill, your brain could put those precious brain cells to work in other important thinking. To put it simply, being kinda right gave cavemen the best chance of surviving. But being kinda right in wildly complicated things like financial markets can really get us in trouble. Markets have countless variables, but our simple brain just can't help itself. When making investment decisions, we continually seek out easy solutions even though they aren't there. For example, a CEO sells her shares. You decide the time is right to place your trade, and you come up a winner. You may consciously understand that your investing decision win could have been just luck, but your subconscious brain doesn't work like that. Your deep instinctual brain just got a hit of that sweet dopamine, and it wants more. So when the same situation comes up again, subconscious bias will try to influence you to repeat the behavior. Maybe your conscious brain can stop you, but maybe not. Unfortunately, our very instinctual brain constantly seeks out overly simplistic solutions. An unfortunate example of this is a market trend called the head and shoulders effect. When the head and shoulders effect turns up, the market sees three peaks, with the middle, the head, being the highest. Investopedia proclaims that this predicts a bearish trend reversal, and it's one of the most reliable trend reversal patterns. But a historical research study found that this pattern doesn't predict anything. Regrettably, another study found that the head and shoulders pattern usually triggers a frenzy of frivolous buying and selling. Trading volume goes up a whopping 40%. So we know our brain is susceptible to behavioral finance biases and seeing patterns that aren't there. But there are also specific situations when you're most vulnerable to this. If you'd like to see another video that lays out when you're most likely to overvalue information, click on the info card right here. So how can you keep your wits about you and resist your instinctual brain's hunger for oversimplistic solutions? Well, most of us have heard of the old saying that we should trust our gut when making complicated decisions. Well, that's the absolute wrong advice, because that little voice in the back of your head is your dopamine-starved instinctual brain talking. And it's really bad at making data-driven analytical decisions. You've got to wrestle this behavioral finance bias to the ground so your conscious, rational brain has more control. Trust the data, not your gut. Right now, I'm working on another video about how cognitive biases tempt us to make bad financial choices. If you'd like to be alerted when that video is completed, just click on my face below to subscribe. And be sure to click that bell too. I've created tons more videos on how brain science can help you make smarter money choices. Click on this box to see the full playlist. I'm Graeme Newell, and that's Better Decisions Through Brain Science.